Hey, I'm checking out the VR zGame again. I actually was just on it, but I didn't get a chance to change this stuff here, so I don't know. There we go. Don't know what all this stuff is. Detail radius should be able to go up, right? With a 1070. You would think. I don't know what occlusion culling is. I don't even know what that is. Camera far plane? Not sure what that is either. Okay, let's do that. Let me put in let's get started here. So far, it still seems like there's way too many zombies coming at you. I mean, it's just kind of ridiculous. They should be spread out. You know, they shouldn't be clustered together. You know, they just should be just wandering around. I never understood that anyway in zombie movies, why they would all like gather together. I mean, once they're done feeding, then technically, they should, I forgot how to run. Oh, that's right. Hold the grip. I still think it could be clear. And it's probably better to play at nighttime with the vibe. Stuck on the fence. Yeah. Lost tracking. Oh, frick. Unbelievable. Damn. If it ain't one thing, it's something else. Jesus. Pain. This game is far from ready. Still pretty clunky, and they got too many zombies coming at you at one time. It's not even scary, it just doesn't make any sense. Not in VR, I mean, because you can't move around as suddenly, and then as soon as they get inside your box, I mean, you get tracking issues sometimes. Yeah, at least I do. I shouldn't have lost tracking at all there. It's ridiculous. Health, I don't need it. So are these guys gonna respawn or what? Yeah, he's in the ground. Nothing's changed. Still got zombies stuck in the ground. It just makes it frustrating to play. I mean, other people are like, you know, happy with running around like that. I'm not. Like I said, the game is worth supporting. See, there's a tracking issue right there again. See? Same thing. Now, I don't know if you can see it. See? Right there. Boom. It's a defective area right there. They didn't fix the sound. I can't tell where they're coming from. Got a lot of work to do, man. I wish they had some kind of a laser sight on here or something. Yeah. See, I don't know if you guys can see it. This is where I was having issues last time. Yeah. stab him right there. I don't know if you can see that in the video, right there. There's a break in the textures right there. And it messes up my everything. It messes up my gun. Let's see. So this is where I was having an issue last time. Just in case you can, there it is, see? I don't know if it's right there. I don't know if you can see that. But you can't do anything. There it is again. So that area right there is broken. It seems like mainly just when you're moving. Yep, see again, my textures came in and out. So there's a little bit of a problem here. I keep seeing a brick building over there or something. Something weird happening. Not good. Can't see me. Graphics still could be a little clearer. I think things are too big. Wow. Oh. That's not supposed to happen. This game is brutal. Too many zombies, man. Too many. There's a broken texture there too. Sliding can make you a little... Uh-oh, there's one in the ground. Oh, great. Yep. Didn't see him. So what, I got one clip left? I need to give us an axe or something. Some kind of melee weapon. You know? That's what I'm waiting for. I wonder if I can hide in here. Probably not. Yeah, they won't come. They won't come until you go down. Bunch of them. Can't move. I got no ammo. Oh, I tried. Anyway, that's the game. I don't really see much different than they had before. It still seems like they have the same problems. Same texture holes in the map. Same clunkiness to the whole experience. I like the idea of the game, but there's too many zombies coming at you at once. That's just There is. It's just too much. I mean, walking around exploring is one of the appealing things to this game. So if you're running around and get mobbed by zombies all the time and then respawn, get mobbed, die, respawn, that's not really fun. I mean, I understand there has to be some kind of survival aspect to it, but to me, that's not fun. You know, the fun to me is running around shooting zombies in the head. You know? Not getting killed constantly. Especially since, you know, you run out of ammo and it's like, okay, so now what? Your only option is to die. Because there is no melee weapon to use. Which I could have killed that last one instead of blowing myself up with a grenade. So, I don't know, Dev. You're doing a good job. But you need to do a lot more to really make this thing playable, appealing. You know, I hate to keep saying it, but you know, this VR hardcore mentality is getting old. And I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one with that mentality. Because, you know, we're not using a game controller. We're using our head, our legs, and our hands, and our house, you know, to have this experience. So, it's not the same as using a keyboard and controller to go crazy in the hardcore aspect of things. It's, yes, some people can do that. Some people are young. Some people are strong. Some people don't have back problems like I do. I like the whole room scale bit. I like moving around. You know, but you only have, you know, you only have your box. So when, you know, when these zombies are coming running at you, you can't run away. You know, the only tools that you have are what you give us in the game. So, anyway, people, that was my rant to the developer. If you agree with me, then let me know. If you disagree with me, then let me know. Like I said, you know, VR is supposed to be a fun experience. And if you want people to adopt, you know, the VR genre, you can't make everything like extremely difficult. I mean, it's got to be something you can just jump into and go, you know. So, and this is great. I love the open world, you know. I mean, this is what I was hoping for. Of course, I was more interested in a an RPG, you know, kind of a deal where you can run around and fight. You know, you collect loot and everything like that. That's kind of what I wanted. I don't really care too much for these types of games. But I'm tolerating them right now in VR because they're really, that's all we got. But as soon as somebody comes out with a nice RPG, man, I'm jumping all over that. Open world RPG, that's what we need. This is good too, if it's not complicated, if you're not dying constantly, if... You know, that this is the kind of game that would be cool. You know, it's got to be fun, though. It can't just cater to the hardcore crowd. There's more casual players out there than hardcore. Everybody wants to kind of think they're hardcore. You know, these young kids. Most kids are not going to succeed in the hardcore realm, though. Let's face it. There's only a small number of people that really do well in games that are very difficult. You know, let's be realistic here. Most of us are just casual gamers, you know, luckily I have a lot of time on my hands, so I don't have to worry about, you know, having no time, but most people work. You know, and they don't have time to be like, spending hours and hours and hours on a game, you know? So you might have to think about making difficulty settings if you want to keep the hardcore aspect in here, you know, or make us be able to start dedicated servers so we can customize it to our liking. So anyway, that's my two cents, and maybe it's the minority, I don't know, but I doubt it. From a lot of the things I read in the forums, discussions online, the casual VR player is going to be the one to cater to. You know, you have your hardcore people who have jumped on, apparently there's a lot of them that have jumped on the VR bandwagon immediately. But if we're going to want more people to come into the VR realm, then we need to make games that the majority of people can just jump into and play without getting frustrated. That's my opinion. Like I said, I could be wrong. There he comes. Where's he going? Oh, look at this. Grenades, huh? My grenade worked earlier. And why did it drop? What's going on, man? My grenade dropped immediately. Alright, guys. Well, that's enough for me. I think that if the reason why you have the non-clarity in this game is because you got it scaled up too big, a little bit too big. I think if he moves everything back, then it might be clearer. I don't know. That's my opinion again. Because, you know, if I look at this blade of grass close up, you know, I can't say it's clear because it's not high resolution. But when you look close up, like, for instance, let's try this tree. Oh man, not again. I don't want to fight right now. See, like, if I look close up here... Well, it isn't blurry. I mean, it's still blurry because it's not high resolution. And, you know, you should be able to take cover in this game, too. That's another thing that I want to see more of. You know? Should be able to duck behind things and get these guys stuck. I mean, you can kind of do that now, but you're not really using cover. Just use an exploit. You're just getting them stuck on the... Oh, there's a shotgun. Look at that. Where did that come from? Now how do you reload this thing? Now this thing should blow a hole in you, so how do you reload this thing? Get mobbed again. Yeah. slow. Definitely can't do that. Yeah, cover. Gotta be able to use cover. This game needs a lot of work. I mean, the people that are writing in the discussions about how excited they are and how great the game is, and I'm sorry, developer. The game is good. The idea is good, but the gameplay is not really that good yet. So I hope we can work on that quickly so we can get this thing moving along. Yep, look at that. No problem there. So that's something else I didn't notice. There we go. I think it worked. Why did that happen? All right, guys. Thanks for watching. See you.